And it's the D-list. Okay, what did not make the air this week? And you notice we're doing this early? Just because the guy behind the camera is going on vacation in an hour? But anyway,
Bahamas.
Yeah, but anyway, what's probably not going to make it on the air for the rest of the week? Well, I've got something, but let's see what you have first.
Okay, well, you remember the last time we did this, I told you about the guy who got impaled on the fence?
Yes,
and
yes.
And it went through his groin and went out his buttocks?
Yes.
That was in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And do you remember it was because of a drug called Flakka?
Yes, yes.
Well, I've gotten a lot of questions about Flakka since then. And then there's another story, and it's in Florida. Fort Lauderdale police called to chase this guy who was walking naked on a busy roadway and behaving erratically. 34-year-old took off when the cops got there, prompting a foot chase. The guy, butt naked is the way he's described, running down Broward, where he does a loop in the middle of the intersection. He told officers he had been smoking the synthetic drug Flakka. So you're wondering, well, what is Flakka? Well, I found out what Flakka is. It's an amphetamine-like drug found in bath salts, or similar to the one found in bath salts.
Oh, yeah, the bath salts turning bath everybody into, like,
and
zombies.
Now it's in Florida. There's been reports of it elsewhere, and that was what the guy who got impaled, he was doing, and that's what the naked guy running down the street was doing. So Flakka, be on the lookout for Flakka.
From you, Dad. I learned it from you. Okay, one other thing for the D-list this week. Now, this is not a New Jersey story, which is probably why it never made the air. This is actually not even in the country, it's the UK. I just thought it was funny. This is a case of a guy's religion his religious rights being trampled. This is in the UK. He goes to have his driver's license photo updated, and they would not let him do it. This was the photo that he wanted to use. Yes, that is a colander on his head that you would strain spaghetti with. Yes, he belongs to the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monster. You may have heard this.
He's a Pastafarian.
He's a Pastafarian. Yes, he is a Pastafarian. They are known as, among other things, wearing the pasta strainers on their heads. They sent him this long letter saying that the integrity of the driver's license, yada, 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 they will not let him do it. He says this is incredibly unfair. He says, I have a spiritual connection with the flying spaghetti monster. Until they have brain probes, how are they going to say that I don't? Our religion is a minority, but the DVLA, that's like their motor vehicles,
right,
is discriminating because it allows people who practice major religions to wear headgear in their pictures. If Tom Cruise has a driver's license, then this guy ought to have the picture.
Well, that's always their point. That the Flying Spaghetti Monster Church says if you're going to make accommodations for a religion,
there you go.
Got to make one for ours. All right, hey,
there you go.
Have a great week. We'll see you next week on the D-List.